Good morning, everybody. Woo, it's sunny again. Yay. It's Friday today.
At last.
Yesterday was just miserable. It was overcast and dark, and it wasn't that cold, but it was raining a lot. I got absolutely soaked, which is never fun. I just pulled over to get Starbucks coffee and to set the camera up. Oh, wedgie. Jesus Christ. Apologies if you can see the cable. So I didn't use the camera yesterday. It was just sat in my briefcase, and I think the Wi-Fi drained the battery. Oh God, I'm getting too fat for this. Go on a diet again. Right, today we are off to a place just between Chippenham and Bristol first. And then we're going to Swindon. Get the old sunglasses back out again. Yesterday I went to Devizes. If you watched the other video when I went to Andover, come on, stupid lorry, change gear. I hate this lorry. If you watched the other video when I went to Andover, I said I bet something would come in that sort of general area next day, and of course it did, because I ended up in Devizes. Now to get to Devizes, I went through Chippenham. And guess where I gotta go today? Chippenham, yay. So yet again, I'm going to pretty much the same place as yesterday. Well, part of it anyway. Never mind. Apart from the weather being crap yesterday, it was just a really weird day in general. The traffic was just really bad everywhere. Like places where it's not usually bad. I mean, I expect it in certain places, just like every day, but there's just like completely random traffic jams. Just as I came off. I came off the M5 onto the M4, up past the Bath Junction, up to the Chippenham Junction, and about 5 miles before that junction, the Matrix signs flashed up pedestrian in road or something. And I thought, well, yeah, we quite often see that sign, and there's workmen in the road and stuff like that doing gully cleaning or whatever they do. A bit further along, the traffic came to a standstill, and we started crawling along, and there was a bloke actually walking down the road on the M4, which is a little bit weird. He was on the hard shoulder when I saw him, but I think I saw him, I saw something ahead. I didn't really see it properly, but I saw something what looked like dash across from one side of the motorway to the other. So it might have been him crossing over all the lanes, all six lanes, to get to the side that I was on. And he started walking down the hard shoulder. I came off at the Chippenham Junction. I overtook him and came off at Chippenham. And that was all to a crawl as well, so we were in like 2 miles an hour. He actually walked past me. I was up on the slip road, he walked past my right hand side. And then a transit van, wasn't the highways agency, but a motorway maintenance type vehicle, pulled up behind him and with his flashing lights on and called him over. I think he must have been foreign, so he just kind of stood there shaking his head and then just walked off again. The last I saw of him, he was walking under the Chippenham Junction Bridge. And then at the end of the day, on the way back, I was coming back down through Cirencester, down the 417 or 419, whichever one it is, I forget. And there's a bad accident on the single carriageway bit at Netherton Bottom that goes to Birdlip Hill, the air balloon. So that was completely shut. It's causing absolute chaos. They shut it at the roundabout, at the sort of top end. The air balloon roundabout was closed, and they closed it at the other end a bit further up. So all the Arctics and lorries were having to go back around the roundabout, back up to Cirencester. There were cars just parked everywhere because they didn't have a clue where they had to go. And there is another little turning off that roundabout that goes through a couple of little villages. A few cars went down there. I went that way because I know of a little shortcut route that I'm allowed to take, but not many people know about it. But as I came to that turning, the road was just completely jammed because some bright spark in an Arctic had decided to try and take that road. And it's a single track road with no passing places. And of course there's traffic coming the other way, he went down and there's nowhere for anyone to go and it was just blocked completely. So I actually managed to shoot off to the left. It's like a T-junction you come down to. It's a road I have taken before, but not in this lorry. I've done it in our old van, and I've done it in my car. But I think I made a boo-boo. There's no weight limit on it, or width limit, or anything like that, but it was just so narrow. I was actually like starting to poo a little bit, because it was getting so narrow. So even the best truckers in the world like me make mistakes. I really shouldn't have gone down there. I'm certainly not going to do it again. Thankfully, nothing was damaged. A few scratches probably down the side of the lorry, but apart from that, thank God no one was coming the other way because I would have been screwed. I couldn't really go anywhere. It's a really good shortcut if you've got a car, but in a lorry, not so much. I was going to show you my gadget, wasn't I? That's the other thing I said on the last video. I don't know if you can see it, possibly. Bought myself a new watch. No, it's not an Apple Watch. My wife did offer to buy me one for my birthday, but I didn't really want to spend that much on something like that. This is a Pebble Steel. It's quite cool. It's quite basic in what it does, but it's quite nice. It tells the time, obviously, and temperature, and it's got like a fitness app on it to track your steps and tracks your sleep. Control your music on your phone with it. It flashes up your text messages and when someone rings you. There's loads of apps for it you can download. There actually is one to control the GoPro, but I haven't got it to work yet. Need to investigate how to set that up. I couldn't find any way of pairing the Pebble app to the GoPro. Usually they cost about 150 to 170 quid. I got this one on eBay for 45. Which I think was a bit of a steal, to be honest. Steel. I just got that. Pebble Steel. It was a steal. It's only a black and white screen. It's very similar to the Kindle screens, if you've ever seen or had a Kindle. It's that kind of they call it e-ink. They call this screen e-paper because it's technically slightly different technology, but it's basically the same thing. It's really easy to view, even like in bright sunshine. Quite happy with it, really. Trouble is, I did start looking at Apple Watches yesterday. I'm thinking, because this does have its limitations, there's stuff it just can't do. I was like, Apple Watch can do that. My wife's actually got an Apple Watch, which is why I didn't really want one, because I've seen like what hers can and can't do, and I was just like, for that amount of money, hell of a lot of money to spend on something that doesn't really do any more than what your phone does. The hands-free, go away, fly. The hands-free call thing's pretty cool on the Apple Watch, but I've got Bluetooth in here, I've got Bluetooth in all my cars, so it's not, don't really need that. So I'll stick with this for now. I'm quite happy with it. Might wait for like the next generation Apple Watch, see what that's got to offer. Just drove past another Matrix sign on the M4 here, saying the M20 expect really long delays because of Operation Stack until Sunday. I feel really sorry for all those lorry drivers stuck there because of all this crap going on in France and Calais. Just because some stuck-up French twunts want some more money, or whatever the hell it is they're moaning about this time. We're bloody moaning about something. They're basically causing misery for hundreds of people. And this migrant thing, all these migrants getting on all these trucks and even on, like, just in people's cars and stuff, and then getting over here, it's just out of order. The French need to pull their bloody finger out instead of just standing around saying, it's not our problem. Bloody well is your problem. Been several things in the paper last week of lorry drivers handing over immigrants they found in their truck when they're in the UK, and they still get fined, and it's like £2,000 fine per person. Absolutely out of order. It's encouraging truck drivers, if they do find immigrants in their lorry, just to let them free. Why are you going to hand them over to the authorities if you know you're going to get whacked with a great big fine for what you think is doing the right thing? It's all very well immigration saying, you've got to make sure your truck is secure. I'm sure all these lorry drivers are making sure their truck is secure, but when you've got a bunch of 100-odd immigrants surrounding your truck with crowbars and hammers and God knows what else, if they want to get in, they're going to get in. There's nothing you can do about it. And these immigrants are sneaky. They're cutting padlocks off, climbing in, and someone else is locking it up behind them, so it looks like it's secure. Now, how the hell are you supposed to combat that? For God's sake, they're truck drivers, not bloody immigration officials. It's not their job to be policing the borders. Someone needs to get it sorted and quickly, because it's out of order. Send the army in if they have to properly police the borders. Search every single lorry that's coming in, every single vehicle that's coming in over the border. Search them all top to bottom. The only way they're going to get around this. Especially with this, all these threats of terrorism now, and ISIS and all that lot saying they're integrating their terrorists into all these migrants coming over. I quite believe that. And what are we doing to stop it? Absolutely bugger all. What the French doing to stop it? Absolutely bugger all. There's my rant for the day. That's that job out of the way, nice and easy. Makes a change. That sun's starting to get hot now though. It's coming right through down onto my chest. Chest is burning. Doesn't help, but I'm still red raw from the sunburn. So we've got about 40 minutes drive to the next place. Hopefully the traffic in Chippenham's okay, because the last few times I've been through there, it's been pretty bad. A lot of random people just walking around in strange places this week. I had another one, was it yesterday? It might have been the day before. I was on a main road like this, and there's some woman running down it towards me on this side of the road. And then there's a big flat grass verge off to her other side. Instead of running up onto that to get out of my way, she just stayed on the road, and there's a truck coming the other way, so I couldn't pull out onto the other side of the road to go around her. So I had to slam my brakes on, and she was just stood there like a bloody lemon. She just would not get off the road and go onto this grassy bit and get out of the way. She'd rather get hit by a truck than run on a little bit of grass for 5 seconds. If you can see that, there's a sign there saying no to the range. I wondered what that was about, so I looked it up online, and the range are planning on building a new RDC distribution center down here. Everything you can see on the left hand side, all these fields, is going to be, well, they're hoping it's going to be one of the biggest distribution centers in this area, possibly in the southwest, possibly in Britain. I think I might be wrong there. But it's massive, and I can see why the locals don't want it built, because it is going to cause absolute chaos. And the traffic's bad down here normally, because this is the ring road around Chippenham, and it's a major trunk route to a lot of places, so there's already a lot of traffic down here. And if they have a massive great RDC, that's going to add even more lorries coming down here. It's just not good. I don't know why they think building it there is good. I'm wondering if they've already started, because they're digging all this up. I don't know if this is something else, or if this is the start of it, if they've got planning for it. But there's a massive petition online, all the locals, to try and get it stopped. Have a feeling they probably won't win, and it will get built anyway. But all of this, everything on the left from that road we're just on, this whole area is going to be part of it. There's so many other places that they could build that without causing too much of an impact. I really don't know why they've chosen here. There's loads of space in Swindon on the 417, where all the other big, the B&Q and the Aldi. I think they're just building another one there now as well for something else. There's still loads of space there, and it wouldn't impact on traffic too much there, because it's already a well-established route, and it's already a pretty ugly place, so it's not going to affect the aesthetics of the area. And it's actually probably better for the trucks to get anywhere, because it's closer to the motorway. Feel sorry for the locals if it does go ahead. Not only that, it's going to cause chaos for however long it takes to build the place. I think there must be some sort of sneaky backhander for the council somewhere, because I can't see how they could get away with planning for that without a bit of a brown envelope job to the lead councillors. I bet this was all part of it. They made all this dual carriageway. This all used to be single carriageway. And I bet they've done this. They've made this dual carriageway all the way through on purpose. Because this would have been one of the main objection points for building it, was that this road couldn't sustain that amount of traffic. Because it couldn't, because this was always clogged up on a single lane. So they've done this, put this dual carriageway all the way through in advance. And I bet someone somewhere knew by doing this it would open up the planning for this new RDC. Obviously I understand they've got to have these RDCs somewhere, but I just don't think Lair is the right place for it. I really don't get the logic in limiting trucks to 56 miles an hour and there's like one, maximum two people in it. Yet a coach that can have like 60 odd people in it can do 60 miles an hour or more. I'm pretty sure he's doing more than 60 there. I just don't get it. Surely a coach doing 60 is more dangerous than a lorry doing 60. It's most bizarre. I never thought a tank could be cute, but if these tanks are near the same as the ones I just passed, they are quite cute. Little dinky things, tiny little gun on it. Ah, these ones are different. It's like a little baby tank with a tiny little gun on the front. Almost there, well, to the junction anyway, not to the job. The job's not far off the junction actually, thankfully. West Swindon's got like the most amount of traffic lights and roundabouts in any city ever. Ridiculous. Nicely indicated, Mr. BMW, well done. Roundabout with traffic lights, which aren't working at the moment. Look, another roundabout. Oh dear. Done and done. I was so tempted to go down that road into Greg's. Kill for a ham salad sandwich right about now. Oh, guess what, guys? Another roundabout. Another roundabout. Why Swindon? Why so many roundabouts? And the man with the big stick thing. Go. Swindon Council, so wasting money on hundreds of bloody roundabouts, why don't you fix the damn roads? Take to inspect a railway? About 10, obviously. Now we've switched from roundabouts just to traffic lights, because there's hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of sets of traffic lights down here, and usually I get stopped at every single one. So we've cleared that one. Oh, looks like we might clear this one. Unless they change stupidly quick. Stay green. Stay green. Woohoo! Oh, bloody Nora. As I thought, I've been stopped at every single set of traffic lights since those two that we went through. Change, please. Oh. If they got rid of all these traffic lights and roundabouts, you'd get through Swindon hell of a lot quicker. The reason it takes so long is you have to keep stopping every 2 minutes. Really? That can't be legal. No number plate. Well, I guess that. Oh god, frog. Excuse me. That's it for this video, I guess. I shall see you all next week sometime. Hope you have a good weekend. See you all soon.